All right, we got another episode of The Grind. So I know it's been a while. Things that have changed. DA is now in the Atlantic League with the Long Island Ducks, doing really well. So this is the season right now, so won't have any DA in here. So best of luck to him. We'll be watching him this year. Also, too, some new things on the horizon, looking to get a new facility to expand and grow. That's going to hopefully be happening soon. But we got some awesome guys training in here right now. Unfortunately, these are injured guys because it is the season. So today you're going to be watching Matt Marksberry a little bit. Matt Marksberry was with the Braves last year in the big league club. We did a little show about him. If you want to go to toplossy.net, check out the show of talking about his most recent injury. And he's feeling great, so we're going to kind of watch him today. And then we've also got Cole McKay, who is at LSU. He's now transferring to JUCO. He was drafted in, I think, the 30th round. He's was a top prospect in 2015. We'll show some highlight film of him right here. Yeah, and so we got a lot of big hopes for him. If you want to watch the most recent biometric analysis we did of him, he's just dealing with some serious hyperangulation issues, actually one of the worst I've ever seen. So I'm really hopeful and excited about him, because once we fix these hyperangulation problems, his arm issues are going to go away, and he's going to throw harder as well. So we're really excited, because he's a beast of an athlete, and this is going to be fun. You're going to get to watch me work with him today as well. So let's get started. Pretty excited about the grind, man.
The ball's where it's at.
For example, tell them what you're working on. Tell them what you're working on. If I can break into him. Sorry, he's in his zone here. Let's see if I can get him out of the zone. Matt, tell him what this is helping you with.
This is helping me learn to drive with my legs, also keeping my back knee out, and also the separation between my hips and my shoulders.
Cool. So, are you able to get it to rotate much? Like, are you still struggling to get it to rotate through?
It's harder to do when I'm pushing. It's easier to do it when I'm. So like that, it like limits you for me at least.
Because you were, I know you're, when you were bruising your hip.
It's easier to do it when I have nothing behind me pushing me back. So.
Yeah. Because what it is probably you're a speed guy. So that moment you want to burst, and that was when it was beating your hip up. So you're just kind of like driving it to that point. Cool. So like where do you feel, like what muscles do you feel really working?
Inner. My inner thigh, and then my hammy, my hip, because I'm really trying to push, keep my knee out. So I'm really thin in here, and then when I push my groin and my hammy, because my hammy's pushing
through. Do you feel like that atrophied a little bit from the season? Mechanically?
During the season, you don't really focus too much on hip mobility or any like mobility or anything like that, or keeping your knees out. You just get your lifts in, and you really start just focusing on throwing strikes and, you know, playing in the game and stuff. So other than that, it's like sometimes you lose sight of what you did in the off season.
Yeah, and like we saw, he became very quad dominant. I don't know where he was before he came here, but he was really quad dominant. His quad strength was like twice of his hamstring strength. So a lot of like when he would get into loading and driving, it was he wanted to internally rotate his back or leg really quickly. So talk about how your back leg, that's helped your back leg stay kind of externally rotated or loaded longer, don't you feel?
Yeah.
I mean, do you feel like that's what
helped? That just has helped, but also, so back in like 2015 when my mechanics were actually pretty good, I really like focused on sitting down and driving out, and I did have my knee out. Compared to when I stay in tall, when I'm standing tall, like your knee tends to go forward, and I was just kind of like pushing downward instead of like loading.
So show them that. So it's like when you came here, you wanted to, when you would come set, your knee would want to even internally rotate,
like that.
Kind of exaggerate it. You would even want to go more, yeah. And then when you would lift, what would happen?
I had nothing behind it, so I would like just collapse.
And you would want to open early, right?
Yeah, lead and turn.
So now with that sled, what do you feel like that sled's doing?
It's helping me with keeping my knee out.
And sitting harder.
So I can.
And then powering out of it more?
Yeah.
Yep. And you feel you can separate more into it?
I can separate more. Less stress on my arm. I just feel like with less effort, the ball comes out a little harder with that less effort than using your arm, as to say.
Cool. I mean, on top of that, I mean, tell them too, you have been working really hard on your back strength.
Yeah.
You've been
back
working
strength, upper body strength, overhead strength, and really like focusing on when I do my lower body extremities, keeping my knees out when I'm squatting, keeping my knees out when I'm doing the split squats, all that stuff to really just teach my body to get the mobility with that, and then just the mobility training in general, helping my hips get more loose.
And you were saying, I mean, you feel pretty damn healthy. I mean, don't you?
I feel really good.
Even though you haven't hit your pin, started working.
Yeah, I mean, I haven't, but I mean, like when I was in rehab with the organization, like there's days I went in and I was throwing, and I was like, damn, I hope I can get through this throwing sesh. But now it's just like, I feel pretty good. I mean, every now and then it gets sore, but it's not even near as bad. And I bounce back so much quicker. And
so how far do you feel like you are from like being able to get into a season and feeling good?
Like a month or two. I feel pretty confident that if I continue my throwing program, plus this mobility stuff, plus the biomechanics stuff, plus the drill work, I feel like if I put that all together and I keep continuing to do it, regardless of my, should be back to normal, if not better. I mean, it might take me a while to build my velocity back up just because I haven't thrown with intent and off a mound in almost a year. So it's like,
right,
it's going to take a while, but I feel it. I feel like it'll come back quick, hopefully.
Cool.
Your timing of movement looks good. Like, I like how, even though you were so high, when you hit here, you're still delaying everything. Mm-hmm. Get low. I think the thing for you is just getting low. Low. That was it.
Stay low. Get low.
I messed up.
But see, I would. But
it's hard to be. It's not like I haven't done it in a while.
But the point is that to me, even.
My legs are a lot better, I feel.
But you're going so much slower and you're separating. You're like giving your arm time. Mm-hmm. And they freeze your arm up. Your arm doesn't feel stressed, right?
Mm-hmm. So I feel like throwing too. It's just.
Yep, freeze your arm up. You should never let your arm get caught in between the movement, it just destroys it. I mean, that's why guys are always like, well, how do I toss nice and easy going through these movements? You still implement the lower half, and what happens is, in the delay, you just kind of let the energy die off, but you still go through all the delay and the separation, and then you just kind of let it die off at that point. But you still feel the whole movement.
Throwing, though, like you continue the energy.
And you start picking it up, and then it's like, wham, as opposed to just walking out and just tossing like this.
So I've been doing like, right before I toss, like even when we're like 5 feet away, I go like this.
Exactly. Yeah. Trying to even hit and still be back here and hit. Boom, and then go to the move. Yep. All the time. Because
I've been doing that.
Because if you don't do that, what, you know, if you're doing this, you're gonna slip out of those habits.
Yeah, and then form a new one.
Yeah, and all of a sudden you're gonna be start, you know, separating in the morning and not driving. Jahar, you really gotta work with that thing. To lay your trunk, lead through your hip, and come out of your shoes in your drives.
All right, Matt's out on the field throwing, so we'll go check him out. See what he's up to, how he's doing. He's getting close to preseason. He's trying to build up some volumes of throws. So kind of out of our off-season programs at this point, moving more into the preseason.
I feel like it's coming out better when I'm...
Yep. Like I said, it's just when you start cranking it up, how much of your legs are cranking it up, or is it your arm? That's gonna be the challenge when you start to crank it up. Yeah. Am I using my legs to crank it up, or am I using my arm to crank
it up?
Like
this, I'll stand still and use my legs all the way.
And you gotta sit into it. Yep, there you go.
That just sucked, guys. I gotta get used to that.
What, that scoop?
Fucking brutal, bro. Come on. Two seam comes out better than my four seam right now. Wonder why.
It's probably because you're not getting a lot of trunk. I think a lot of trunk helps it finish. Boom. You got to get your trunk through your front leg.
I'm on flat ground.
I know. But it gets harder for you to get your hip through, and then you got to stick your front leg harder. Remember, slam your front leg. I just see that coming out of your head. Pulling your head down and not pushing your hip, your front leg back. That's better. There you go. How'd that feel? See, when you get, that's what happens. When you get a couple steps behind it, then you feel that energy hit your front leg, and your front leg actually pushed back a little better.
That one felt like it came out good.
Medlin's throwing today.
Is he squat?
He's playing.
GCL? GCL already started?
No, he's extended still. But they went to Yankees. I think they went to play the Yankees a little extended spring training game. Tell your story, man. Tell them why you're here.
Threw hard out of high school. Had good mechanics. Went to LSU and kind of lost it and hurt my arm. Had surgery on some nerves in my arm. But you know, the basis of it was, you know, I lost all my mechanics. Came here. And
day four
already worn out.
Yeah, we haven't really started training officially.
Yeah, exactly. But it's fun stuff, you know, looking to get some hip mobility, open up the hips, start firing the legs efficiently, and
stop dragging the arm.
Stop dragging the arm, get the arm healthy. I believe in it.
Now you got to do it.
That's right.
So talk about, what are your goals at this point in your life?
Next year I'm going to a junior college and, you know, looking to get healthy first and start chunking the ball again. And definitely get drafted out of junior college, get some looks, go to pro ball, if not another D1.
Cool. So you'd be happy with going to pro ball right after JUCO?
For sure.
What's your favorite team?
Texas Rangers.
Rangers?
Gotta stick with the home state.
You grew up going to a lot of those games?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
It's pretty sick.
You like Nolan back in the day? Was he too old for you?
Oh no. He's my favorite pitcher ever.
Yeah, mine too.
Yeah.
Good. Clemens, you like Clemens?
Yeah, Clemens was my coach in high school for the Banditos. Played with his son.
Oh, you played with the Banditos?
Yeah. No way. Yeah. Played with his son, Cody. And yeah, so he was our like pitching coach. Him and Shane Reynolds.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
He's a pretty cool guy.
A real cool guy, yeah. It's huge.
Hey, I think you got it. Start your full stride. Start your full stride first. Number two, your thick hips, you still gotta understand, to stabilize this leg, it has to be across your body. So the best place to be is toe to heel. If you're over there, what happens is if you push your hips all the way open, they'd be pointing that way. We wanna make sure when we hit, we can push our hips all the way through and be taking us to the target and be locked down.
Okay.
So you wanna be, for you, it's gonna feel, because you got thick hips, you're gonna feel across your body. So you're going toe to heel.
Yep.
Trying to land there and you drive. Drive through that hip flexor. Trunks out a little bit and set the flexor. You're doing good. Just try to push the hip flexor up. Keep the trunk loading back. I don't want you lifting too high. I want like a couple of inches and then pop it through. But
okay.
Remember, I think you need to do this because your toe.
Yeah, a little higher.
And I want to put the velo throw on you too. Where'd you put the velo throw back? Feel that hip push through in this low back, you're like, oh yeah, and then you let it go. Try to, after that, allow your trunk to be your arm. Yeah, you let your trunk go a little early. That's the thing, it's like, you try to get your trunk and then you start it early. Still,
right.
Still, you feel the back hip pop through, and this load, and then your upper body takes off.
Okay.
want to do that again. If you let your arms go earlier, that's okay. So you lost 4 miles an hour by not taking your trunk out of it. Same thing, put all that energy through your whole body.
Say that again.
When I sit down in it and do it your way, it's faster, but it feels slower.
The ball speed's faster, but your body feels slower. It's because what you're doing, like I was telling you, is there's more range of motion. So you go from these short little ranges where, I feel quick, but you're just, all that's happening is you're not moving far.
Yeah.
So it feels faster.
Yeah.
And then you push your hips through harder, your trunk moves farther. Now it feels slower because you're going farther and you're not releasing the ball as quickly, but it's just really because you're going farther.
Right.
But potentially that's how you generate more velocity on the ball. You give it more time and you put more force behind it through time.
Yeah.
But I mean, what do you think the Velo Pro, the harness is doing for you?
Helps me keep my weight back on my leg, and it helps me load my back leg longer so I can explode through it at the end. And if I don't have it on, I just go forward.
Yeah, you want to keep transferring forward. So it's really great device for teaching the load, how to load into the hip. All right, we're going to do some separation throws.
So on these, you need to lower your center of mass as you drive. It just went up, and I'm going to be in the MLS. So like this. Tighten this up. This is just externally rotating and rotating. Okay. You want to feel it like we did with the football. We're gonna feel it. Supinate, externally rotate, internal rotate, pronate. Okay. You want to go here. By your arms used to throwing.
Oh,
Jesus. I'm turning this
way. Yeah.
It's used to doing this.
Yeah.
It's used to doing this movement.
Yeah.
We want to create more of this movement.
Okay.
Yeah. And let it. Yeah, use your trunk. Look, use your trunk.
Okay.
Your trunk gets it going. Use your trunk. Throw your trunk back. Before. There you go. Good. just like you were here. So you're gonna lift and you're gonna drive into the movement. So get your front foot out a little farther. Lift and drive into the movement. Okay, put the harness on. It's the only way you're gonna survive this.
That one fell off, I think.
Did you?
Yeah, you can.
That ball feels like it's not even an ounce.
Yeah.
But so what you have to do is you have to pick up speeds with the baseball.
Yeah.
So you got to be able to move even faster through those movements.
Okay.
But here's the thing. Because you don't do a lot of external instrumentation, be careful. You're going to get pretty sore up under here because you're not used to that external rotation.
Okay.
So I wouldn't crank it up too hard enough. Still focus on lifting and driving. Okay, you're leaving your hip behind and you're pushing your head up.
Okay.
And you lift.
When you lift right here, put this a little farther out. When you lift, I feel that hip pop up as this loads back. It's like that. And then everything goes.
And that, put this out a little farther.
You gotta put this in position to where that's already ready to push up.
Okay.
Tuck your glove hard. Don't turn. Lift and push that hip through hard. Lift, push that hip. You want to do this a little bit. Focus just right here. Hold this position. Up, push the hip through. I don't care about the speed of the ball right now. I want to see that hip push through. Get your trunk back a little more. Yep. Going like this.
Fuck.
You really gotta fight the turn because the turn is cheating your leg drives.
Okay.
So see, as you're lifting your arms, your elbows going back. Keep your foot down in this drill too. Okay, that was better. You didn't completely throw your glove side out.
Okay.
But I don't want your elbow going that far back because that's what you want to do every time. You want to just throw your elbow back and then slam it forward. That's what's hard on your arm. So I want you to try to hold it as much as you can here. You have all that room, and I know your body wants to find stability, but if you tuck this glove side really hard, and you can pinch that back a little bit, but if this one starts doing this, then this one's gonna wanna go all the way back here. So keep this one tucked really hard, so this one only has to go right there, and then hold that position, just like when you do the overhead throws and you put your elbows forward.
Okay.
So when you're hitting your drives, see how your arm's going back and forward like that?
Yeah.
Everything else I'd like, I just want to try to get you stabilizing this more here and not turning all the way back. Yeah, so if you pull this back really hard.
And like don't let it come out.
Yeah, then this one can't go back as far. So it's gonna stay right here.
Okay.
And then just emphasize your lower half, just like you did with the med balls in your elbows for. Emphasize your lower half.
Okay.
Lift and push your back hip through. That's better. But see, you still wanted to push out. We wanna try to shut that down. So when we drive, the trunk goes and the arm just turns over. There's no push at that point. That's the only way we're gonna clean up you wanting to overuse your arm. Load that really hard, a little external rotation, big emphasis on lift and drive, then your trunk catapults, and then foot out a little farther. All that does, when your trunk goes forward, it just does this. I don't want to see you pulling or pushing your elbow.
Okay.
So just focus on your trunk. Feel your front leg kick back at the end, and feel your trunk slam, and your arm just ride that trunk. Okay. No arm in this. You're shutting this down and you're shutting that down. So you got to be able to pick that up while you're shutting this down.
Okay.
So shut the top down but pick the bottom up. Come on. Put this in position, load it, tell it it's just going to stay here. That's going to blow and then this is going to kick back and the trunk is going to catapult hard. A little better. Try it again. So any of this, if you feel any of that movement, wham, I want to get it out. I just want this right now. I just want boom.
Jump catch.
That's gotta be more than five. What was that?
That was.
I think that was way more than five.
Look,
specifically when it gets heavy, you gotta, all it is trying to get out of your shoes. You're just going boom. You let, your arms are just cables at that point. You just try, literally feel like you're gonna jump out of the building. Boom! And then let it fly and then catch the bar. It's a better approach. We'll just stay right here until you get more comfortable, because you're just going, you're getting tired, these are shutting down.
Hey, it's all got tall arms.
Yeah. Okay, so if you see your veins swelling, you're using your arms. Lower half dominant here, just through all these reps and the loads.
Yeah.
And it's gonna make you want to be more lower half dominant in there.
Okay.
Come on, jump. Don't pull. Jump. Jump. Good, there you go. You catch it, good. Jump, catch. Make your legs work. Jump, catch. Catch. Good.
Yeah, that was easier than last year.
I mean, what that does, because you're turning everything on.
Yeah.
So a guy who's trying to do too much strength lifting, somebody's doing strength lifting, he's just pulling, and everything's slow. Okay. When we get into power, it's quick, explosive movements. Okay. Also, too, is that's what shuts your CNS down. When you're sitting there moving that quickly,
yeah,
and you're going boom, you're turning it on that quickly,
uh-huh.
Your CNS is going to fry. So tomorrow you might not feel like, you'll feel sore, but you'll actually feel more drained, like physically drained.
Okay.
This is good. That's what is going to take you from low 90s to mid 90s.
What's
is when
chop?
You can turn it on.
Yeah.
All right, we've got three on these.
Three sets, yeah.
Three?
Let me check again.
Just fly up. Jump, jump it up. Jump. Okay. It's kicking your ass at the end.
Think about it, that's not even your body weight. It's crazy, huh? So just imagine when you're cleaning like 300 pounds. You're a freaking freak. So I don't think people understand.
That's insane.
All right, what's the next one?
Power clean, 65%.
Let's see with that, try to build up. So power clean from the floor. So like, remember we did them all together? We're gonna go slow, transition, and then up.
Okay.
All right, so you gotta add in that transition.
You gotta push your butt back and pull this up, but keep my balance there. Like I can go like all the way back here. You're just like this. You're like up here like this. You gotta go down and up.
Butt down, trunk up.
Butt down, trunk up. That's the way we like to.
Yep. Pull it in a little more and go, go. This so hard your feet kick back. You want this can start to kick back, but when you get here, you start pushing them forward. Keep your butt down. You're going like quickly up. Keep it down and feel like this coming up more.
That one looked a lot smoother though.
Yeah, you still want to pop.
But yeah.
Put it all in your glute. Pull your trunk up. Your glute's gonna pull your trunk up. Open your glute up, put all this load in the glute, start lifting your trunk up. Lift your trunk up from the beginning. A little better. Just, you don't want to jump forward. That just tells you you're lean, your trunk is forward and your trunk needs to get up.
Okay.
So first day, what's like it felt like going through first day?
It's definitely a lot of work, but you know, the hammies are a little juiced and the legs are juiced, but I feel like we got a lot of good work in, a lot of good hip flexibility work in, mobility work, and strengthening work. So
cool. And then all your biomechanics work as well. Exactly. Are you feeling like with how the Olympic stuff correlates in as far as the similarities and how we move the bodies and the dynamics of the body movements to the throwing?
Yeah, definitely. Working, you know, ground up when you're throwing makes sense to do that when you're lifting too. And it's definitely something I haven't done, which is why I've struggled with mechanics in the past. But even just after a day of doing it, I can feel where I haven't worked and how it would help me on the mound.
Yeah, and when you were in your deep squats, you were really unstable.
Yeah.
So you can see you don't have a lot of stability where you're building power down there.
Yeah.
Well, cool. So excited, man. So what progress are you really looking forward to making in the program?
I'm looking forward to definitely loosening up the hips, able to freely move those down the mound, and get the glutes stronger, the hams stronger.
But as far as as far as the whole package, like you came into this more focused on health or both health and velocity?
Definitely both health and velocity. You know, health is obviously huge because you can't pitch with a hurt arm, so I'd say that's first. And then, you know, I think what we're doing here definitely correlates with the velocity, obviously. Yeah. So
definitely. I mean, most of our testimonies there. So you'll be actually in a smaller list of those that just came here for health. Just we don't get a lot of those guys, but I think you can see that progress that you should at the end of this, and we're going to try to follow you obviously with the grind, hopefully, and we'll see you make those gains. You're going to get healthier, and you're going to get, you know, you're going to help, your performance is going to go up with that. So
all right. Yeah.
Cool, man. Next time.
All right. For sure.